Welcome to Kit Close-Up. I'm James Mora, a senior staff editor at Electronic Design. Virtually every high voltage power system depends on fuses to protect itself, the load, and the wiring from damaging levels of current. But passive fuses that have dominated for decades at this point are no longer cutting it in many of today's complex power systems. Instead, many are turning to electronic fuses that use power MOSFETs and other devices to actively monitor load current and input voltage to protect against overcurrent and overvoltage events, as well as other types of faults. So recently I was able to get my hands on a reference design for one of these devices from Microchip Technology. The auxiliary E-fuse, as the company calls it, combines a pair of high voltage silicon carbide MOSFETs with onboard current detection and protection. The device itself is designed for electric vehicle systems that run on 400 volt to 800 volt batteries. And the use of silicon carbide gives it a continuous current rating of up to 30 amps, while also improving short circuit withstand time. It's also important to point out that while the device works as is, it's still a reference design. So it's intended to be more of a technical blueprint for you to copy or expand on, depending on a system's requirements. Now let's check out some of the key building blocks in the design and how everything works together. So the fuse itself is based on a pair of four lead 1200 volt silicon carbide MOSFETs from Microchip. These are housed in TO247 packages, and they're strapped vertically into a large heatsink that's there for the purposes of development primarily. So these components, like all the others on the board, are automotive grade. Silicon carbide has a wide range of unique properties that help it safely handle higher voltages, higher currents, when it comes to converting and or distributing power around a system. One of its main advantages over silicon is its low on resistance, which helps keep conduction losses in check. Other qualities include a high tolerance for heat, as well as high thermal conductivity. It's also important to note in this case that the devices have a positive temperature coefficient. So that means you can place them in parallel in a system like this without one hogging all the current. And so in this case, current flows from a high voltage battery into this terminal here, and then into the drain of the MOSFET. Subsequently, the source of the MOSFET sends it through the current sensing resistor, which is located here, that checks for overcurrent events, and then out through the terminal that connects to the high voltage load, which is located here. I also wanted to point out that silicon carbide MOSFETs have faster switching frequencies relative to silicon MOSFETs and IGBTs, and this translates into a faster response time, which means that the fuse or circuit breaker can shut down very high currents and even short circuits before overloading a system. So instead of cutting off current at thousands of amps, which can put a lot of stress on the system, the wiring, the load, you can cut things off at hundreds of amps instead, which can be very valuable when it comes to system design. The electronic fuse itself is divided into two isolated zones, the low voltage zone and the high voltage zone, which includes the silicon carbide MOSFETs, as well as all of the components used to control and drive them. The low voltage zone is used primarily to generate power for the high voltage side of the fuse, and it uses the green connector at the top of the PCB to connect to a 12 volt bus. The same component is used to connect to the LIN network and communicate with the central ECU or other controller. So power is delivered from the low voltage to the high voltage zone via the isolated bias supply. And this is powered by a Microchip voltage regulator IC, which is located here. The LDO provides a 5 volt output over a continuous battery operating range of 9 volts to 16 volts, which is a standard automotive range. The power supply increases the output from the IC to 24 volts on the secondary side of the device, the high voltage side. And that is used to run the microcontroller at the heart of the fuse, as well as the gate driver. So one of the other key building blocks in the low voltage zone is an 8-bit Microchip MCU, which happens to be located very close to the LIN interface diagonal to it. The MCU is used to output the pulse width modulation, or PWM, signals that control the isolated bias supply.
So power and signals have to travel over a high voltage isolation barrier to go from one side of the device to the other. And isolation is very important in electric vehicles, as you need to make sure high voltages are not straying into parts of a system not designed to accommodate them. So the isolation barrier in this case is comprised of a transformer from Worth Electronic that has an isolation rating of 2.5 kilovolts RMS, and it is placed next to a safety capacitor that supports up to 4 kilovolts RMS. Both of these components are placed over a physical slot carved into the circuit board that separates the low and high voltage zones with 9 millimeters of creepage. On the other side of the device is a digital isolator IC, also placed over the slot in the circuit board, and it facilitates the communication of digital signals from the LIN bus over the isolation barrier. And the IC itself is rated for up to 3 kilovolts RMS. So at the heart of the high voltage zone is a PIC microcontroller from Microchip that acts as the central controller for the auxiliary eFuse. The 8-bit MCU is primarily in charge of the gate driver IC located diagonal to it that in turn connects to and drives the silicon carbide MOSFETs in the device. The primary job of any fuse is to prevent excess current flow in a system, and its ability to do so is represented by its time current characteristic, or TCC curve. This plots how long it takes to trip the device at a given current level. For this reference design, overcurrent events are detected by several different methods, depending on the amount of current and the response times required. So while the PIC microcontroller determines how to proceed once current is detected, the current itself is measured by the shunt resistor that sits between the silicon carbide MOSFETs and the terminal that leads out to the high voltage load. The current sensor feeds into a dual op amp, which is located directly next to the MCU. The component is designed by Microchip to deliver the wide bandwidth and the fast response times required for a device like this. The op-amp itself is connected to the MCU, which uses its internal analog-to-digital converter to monitor for overcurrent events. How fast it can respond depends on the sampling rate of the ADC. So if current traveling through the device leaps over a safe level, the microcontroller detects it and disables the gate driver to shut everything down. The gate driver itself outputs up to 20 volts, to turn on the silicon carbide MOSFETs, and since these devices need negative turnoff voltages, it can deliver down to -3 volts. Other protections against undervoltage lockout and overtemperature are also supported by the MCU. While it takes longer to respond, the device can also detect overcurrent by estimating the junction temperature of the MOSFETs. As the amount of current being handled by these devices rises, the rate at which they heat up also increases, implying that current levels are too high in the system. A thermistor in the high voltage zone takes care of the temperature measurements. Sudden high currents that are too fast to be detected by the ADC and the software inside the MCU, these are deemed short circuits. These surges of current are flagged by the device, and then the hardware on the high voltage side of the eFuse is engaged directly to interrupt them. The device uses the core independent peripherals of the MCU to shut things down in a very short time. These peripherals are designed to do their jobs without any dependence on the CPU, and so they have the response times required to prevent short circuits effectively. While the device itself is designed to trip at set current levels, these thresholds are configurable over LIN. The device also brings diagnostics to the table, so in the event the device trips, you can figure out why. In the end, implementation matters. And so while the base reference design uses an 8-bit Microchip MCU to control everything, it can be upgraded to a more advanced real-time processor depending on the needs of the system. One possibility, as Microchip pointed out, is to use a 16-bit digital signal controller, or DSC, that supports a higher degree of flexibility and performance and a faster sampling rate in the ADC.
Ask Microchip, and the company will tell you that this type of device can be used more or less anywhere you have a traditional high voltage relay, contactor, or fuse. The company cited battery disconnect units as one potential fit for the device, which itself has an operating temperature range of negative 40 to 85 degrees Celsius. These systems act as on-off switches to the 400 volt and in the future 800 volt battery in the EV, and they help disconnect harmful power levels from reaching the rest of the system, and can also be used to shift between different operating modes, specifically charging and driving. Another potential use for the device is in high voltage distribution boxes that connect the battery to various high voltage loads. So for instance, onboard chargers, which consequently can also use these devices as an alternative to a relay. Because of the role these boxes play in the EV, they are typically full of fuses. And so the flexibility of the power electronics in a device like this can be very valuable. The reference design is primarily targeted at EV systems, but as a reference design, it's also suitable for other areas, planes, trains, solar inverters, and other systems such as circuit breakers that live on renewable powered electric grids. So anywhere you have to distribute power at high voltages is a potential landing spot for such a device. And it works across a wide range of current levels from 10 amps to 100 amps to even higher levels of current, whether you are using continuous or pulsed loads. So if you're looking to test out an electronic fuse for the first time, or if you have used one before, but not one based on silicon carbide, check out this design from Microchip. It's potentially a good place for you to get started.